Okay, boys and girls, I hope you found that video very interesting from PBS on Charles McGee. He just passed away in January, and he's an artist from Detroit, Michigan. He has famous murals on the walls, and he has sculptures all over the city. And some people have actually been collecting his work, and they've been fans of his work for a long time. All right, so the interesting thing about Charles McGee, if you notice in this interview on PBS, he talked about how it's a combination of balance, like in nature, where you have, and he's really kind of talking about that negative and positive space, okay? So we're gonna have a lot of fun using black and white this week. All right, so here's one that I worked on. It took me several hours to do this one. You might want to not use the whole sheet of your paper this week. I know you have 9x12 paper. You might decide, just for time's sake, you might wanna fold the 9x12 paper in half and do half of that, okay? That would be 8 and 4.5 inches. Okay, so there you go. So what you wanna do first is you wanna come in. Now, the interesting about Charles McGee is that he does art like this, where it's very abstract, and you're just thinking about if you have something round or organic shapes, which are rounded shapes, and he has some triangles and geometric shapes mixed in. You're really having fun with pattern and line, which you'll have that to share as well. And so you wanna go in and you wanted to start, I just started with a pencil, and I just kinda had fun. I wanted to go with some spirals. I did some different kinds of like pieces and just kind of made my own design. But Charles McGee also does art like this, but he incorporates animals. So if you wanted to incorporate snakes or reptiles or amphibians or birds, you could do something like this and then tie in those different shapes and patterns into your art as well if you wanted to, all right, relating to nature. So I'm gonna go in here and I'm just gonna kind of start to make some continuous lines. So I'm gonna make a spiral here and I'll balance it with a spiral here, kind of like the yin and yang symbol, okay, that you see so often. And then in here, I'm just gonna kind of come in and make like different organic shapes and pieces. And I'm gonna blend that in by making some shapes be more geometric. Okay, so I could put a trapezoid there. I could go in and do a triangle in this corner, maybe another one over here to balance it out. Okay, and I could give some thickness to my spirals, okay? And then what you wanna do is you wanna be thinking of balance all the time. Like what space will be black and what space will be white, okay, when you're working. So I'm gonna follow this pattern. The trick about doing spirals is that you wanna start wherever you decide to start the black, start from the center. So I'm gonna make this black, okay? I'm gonna come out and then slowly I'm going to start to change. What's interesting about Charles McGee is that he had a lot of interesting things to say about his life. He was born in 1924. He almost made it to be 100 years old, which is really awesome. And he really experienced a lot in his life. He was talking in that video about his experiences in the community where he lives in Detroit, where he really witnessed lots of changes that occurred over his lifetime in relation to being a Black American. So in the spirit of Black History Month, that's why we are studying him, okay? And learning about his art, especially since he just recently passed away. Now you'll know about Charles McGee, and if you ever go somewhere and you see one of his prints, or you see in some way, and you see one for sale even, scoop it up because those are gonna be worth a lot of money. Wasn't it interesting to see his sculptures too? His sculptures in black and white are really cool to see in person. They kind of take on like figures. They almost look like people, even though they might be representational. So there I go, I'm starting off with solid, but I could go in and I could start to just have fun. You could just do it all with the marker and have fun. I could do stripes. You could do all kinds of patterns. You can use that pattern sheet to help you. You could do dots. Did you notice that he uses lots of dots? So you could go in and do black dots, and then you could do another part to balance it. You could do white dots with a black background. As you can see here, I did white dots with a black background. I did solid black dots of different sizes. I used variation like blobs, almost like you'd see in a science biology scope when you go and you look at cells at their smallest levels of measurement. Look, I made some solid dots and some stripes there. I did some zigzaggy stripes and some serious like basic stripes. I also kind of took on this snake-like feel with some of my spirals. I did some black backgrounds with white spirals and then the opposite here. All right, so I just had a lot of fun thinking about different ways that I could create pattern. I will have you use the pattern sheets to help you as a reference to help you in your design, but take your time and go slow and really think about if you do a circular shape here, how could you balance it? Like I did spirals here, so I did spirals over here. I have some organic shapes over here with dots, so again, I put represented dots in a different way over here. I even did like cow patch dots, almost like you'd see on cow skin, all right? Zebras, I kind of thought about zebras when I was doing this. So I kind of had an influence. You could do, if there's specific shapes that you really enjoy using, you could use those too. But remember, use some curved shapes along with some straight lines as a combination in your work. This is what we call abstract art, boys and girls. It doesn't have to represent an animal or anything in particular. It's just that thinking about balance, negative and positive space. The positive space is the dark, the black, and the negative space is the white in this case, because the paper originally was white, okay? This is all done with Sharpie. So you might want to use half your sheet because this took me quite a while to do. All right, boys and girls, I cannot wait to see your work and I can't wait to see you in class. Have a great time doing this if I don't see you in class, and I will love seeing your work when you post it to me. Have a good day.